Hello everyone. So from last couple of months I listening this Kef reference one speakers, which is this one. How you know, my R5s are on the left side, and also to make size comparison I got here Bauer & Wilkins CM1 speakers, so you will see the difference in size, because most people saying this is a bookshelf. So what is that for computers, speakers? Not really. So this is proper bookshelf. This one is weight, I think, around 20 kilos. So it's very heavy. You can put two bookshelf, but that's stand mounter. That's how we call. And also we got here this lovely black and silver custom design stands for the speakers. Okay, so we'll talk about sound a little bit. I can compare this reference one to my R5 speakers. I know that different in the price. And that's actually very good, because I can see the difference I paid for. Is that worth it? Because reference 5 is £2,000 and reference 1 is £6,500. So, but about this sound we'll speak later. Now I will show you just this reference 1 all around, how it looks. And also the view from back, because it's something hidden. So I will show you, maybe most people don't know about it. Okay, let's do this. Okay guys, so hide that thing behind. What I want to show you is basically this port design. So you got here like something like plastic screw, but quite big. You turning this, take it off, and inside you got hide that foam port. So in your box you can find two of them, but with different size. This one is short one, and a long one I got in the box. So you can basically, it depends on your room, on your equipment, what you got, and just try, you know, with this one or other one, how sounds better, maybe a little bit deeper or more boomy. You can just swap it and try it. Maybe we'll make some changes in your bass quality. So this is a very nice feature. Another very nice thing is how is finished this terminal speakers. They are made from brass. If you got this fork plugs, it's nice, easy to screw in. Also, you don't need to make any bridge, because it's bolt in. If you're not using this B amping, you got just this link things. You just screwing to the right, and bridge is made. Very nice, the same as R5s, but maybe here is like maybe better quality a little bit. Yeah, also what you will get is that lovely copper plate with number, production number. Also the difference between this speakers and R series is that the reference series is made in the UK, and R series is made in China. That's the difference, you know. Okay, guys, so I show you a little bit all around this speaker. Now let's talk about the sound, the most important thing. Of course, important is how it looks. Not everyone wants to like some ugly piece, keep it in living room. Yeah, this is like part of your furnishment. So, okay, it's beautiful. I can't complain for design and quality. The same like R5 for its price is very well made. But first thing I want to say is you can straight away recognize which one when you can hear the R5 or reference one. They are completely sounding different. I'm not saying better or worse or something like that. Of course, the reference should sound much better, but not for everyone taste. Okay, so first thing which you will notice is maybe bass. The bass is going a little bit deeper, which is awesome. You not expect that from bookshelves or stand mounters, but yes, for in this price, so it should be a little bit better anyway. It's deeper, it's cutted, this mid bass is cutted. R5s have a more this boomy bass, yeah, but it's short, this lower frequency, which reference one has a little bit more. And when I'm listening, like for example, this Beyoncé Partition, I was comparing side by side this song, and I can say, yeah, it's deeper. This bass, you know, digging and digging. You can hear this 7 hertz differences. So the bass, yes, is like a little bit stronger, maybe not stronger, deeper, but you can feel it, you know? Maybe if you're listening here, for example, R5, and you're going to someone else listening this reference one, yeah, you will not feel it, you know? But when I'm doing like 30 seconds listening this speaker, 30 seconds R5, and again 30 seconds this one, and again this one, side by side. Yes, the bass is going lower. Yeah, it's nicest. But that's what I'm saying. You're losing this mid bass. The speakers haven't this mid bass so much. Another thing is tweeters, higher frequency, they are quite bright, smooth, is not overwhelming, it's smooth, but is lots of them, much more than R5s, okay? So that's why when I was listening this reference one, I wasn't listening a long time. My room is quite small. From this reference one, sounds going a little bit more forward because higher frequency. And a little bit after a while, like 45 minutes listening, I'm start like feeling here this, and it's enough. So I just turn it off. With my R5, the tweeters are, you know, like more chilling, much more chilling, and I can listen like straight 2 hours, and I'm not getting, you know, like overwhelming, you know, it's nice. So definitely it's not speakers for me, you know. I was listening not long time ago this speakers PMC 25 series, and I can say they are sound is more similar to my R5, like more smooth tweeters, you know. I'm not saying he is harsh, just is more of them, you know, for different kind of music. I'm listening, you know, like vocal house, dance, pop, you know, modern music, yeah. So I prefer like with less this higher frequency. Okay, and mid-range. Mid-range is very rich. I can say maybe sound maybe more refined, more clean. You know, it's cleaner overall. Overall, from this speaker, is sound sound more clean. Everything is, you know, this less mid bass, higher frequency is more, and the mid range is a little bit maybe like high dead, and it's hard to say. You know, you have to hear that. You know, someone like it, someone not. Overall, speaker is perfect, but is big. You know, this reference one is quite big speaker, even compared to my floor standards. I know it sounds crazy, but they are bigger. You can see how wide is the reference one, how is my R5. Of course, they are maybe lower. This is one thing, because the stands are quite short. Very nice. But overall size and the deep, you know, if you got small room and the speaker is really deep, you need to pull out a little bit from the wall, and it's really, it looks huge in this room. Yeah, it's big. It's all sizes. It's wider, deeper. Yeah. So many people were asking, is worth the money? You know how it is in hi-fi, high fidelity audio. Every another money you will put in, you will get a little bit. Yeah, you have to listening that speaker. If you like it, you will buy it. You know, I haven't like anything to say I like it or not. Yeah, it's cool, but it's not definitely it's not for my room. So yeah, I'm staying now with my R5. Okay guys, so I think for today that's it. If you got any question, just let me know right in the comment. I will try answer for your question. If I will have any another equipment to try, or I will buy something new, I will make another video and I will show you and share my experience. So that's it for now. See you next time. Bye.